Previously, we discussed the emergence of galacticity, or a galactic level awareness, which is one step above hypersociality, two steps above communality of advanced A.I.s, and three steps above the regular consciousness of the human type. Today, we will be discussing the highest level of awareness possible for a sentient being within the universe, known as universality. If you haven't seen the previous videos on this topic, check them out first before watching this one. The link is in the description below. But if you have already seen those, then let's dive right in. The final emergent property of intelligence, according to the concept of sentience quotient, is known as universality. For this level of awareness to occur in sentient beings, they must be able to process data at 10 to the 50 bits per second kg, having an SQ value of 50. An alien being capable of handling data this rapidly would have to be considered a perfectly efficient thinker according to this scheme. So in any given mass category, such an entity would possess the greatest intelligence theoretically possible in the universe. This would make beings at the level of universality incomprehensible for even those at the level of galacticity capable of comprehending the complexities of an entire galactic community. As for beings at lower levels of awareness, such as reactivity, consciousness, communality, and hypersociality, all of them would be virtually indistinguishable for these beings, from the dumbest possible brain that can process one bit of information in a time equal to the age of the universe and a mass equal to the universe itself. Such intelligent beings may be regarded as no less than deities, even by the most advanced galactic standards, let alone all the other lower levels of awareness. For these universal beings, all other forms of sentience would be extremely primitive and backwards, lacking the knowledge of the intricate workings of the entire universe. Now, just how smart could these universal beings really be? Let's relate this level of data processing with something our minds could readily comprehend, such as reading some number of books per some time interval. As mentioned before, it is not efficient to talk about individual books. Rather, we will consider the biggest library in the world, the Library of Congress, which contains over 170 million written and recorded materials. So, for a being at the universal level of awareness, it would take only one picosecond or one trillionth of a second to read and comprehend 400 trillion libraries of Congress. To put this further into perspective, a picosecond is to 1 second as 1 second is to roughly 31,689 years. So given just 1 second of time, these godlike beings could process 400 septillion or 400 trillion trillion times the content of the Library of Congress. Now that is some serious and extreme level of data processing. It is no wonder that all the levels of awareness below universality would be next to nothing. Now, the basic type of sentience that could make the sixth and the final emergent property of intelligence possible could be what we call universal sentience. Similar to how a galactic being would be capable of comprehending the complexities of an entire galactic community, a universal being would be capable of holding in its mind the seemingly incalculably complex orderings of an entire universe full of living systems at all levels of intellectual sophistication. This would include any and all forms of sentience within the universe. So even the most advanced galactic beings would be considered as extremely primitive and partially conscious to these beings at best. The inability of galactic beings to comprehend the inner workings and the complexities of all the living systems in the universe would perhaps seem pitiful and barbaric by the universal standards. But this does not come as a surprise, since beings that could sense the needs of an entire universal community as easily as we humans can sense the need of our own physical bodies would obviously be incomprehensibly superior to any of the levels of awareness below it. So just like how we could teach dogs a few simple tricks to make their lives better, universal aliens may perhaps do the same with galactic aliens to enable them to live together in harmony with other galactic-level intelligence in the universe. But of course, trying to understand a far superior mentality at this level of awareness with our limited senses and knowledge is next to impossible. Perhaps we may never be able to even hope to communicate and understand super beings with SQ plus 50. In other words, in the words of Robert A. Freitas Jr., at present, human scientists are attempting to communicate outside our species to primates and cetaceans, and in a limited way to a few other vertebrates. This is inordinately difficult, and yet it presents a gap of at most a few SQ points. The furthest we can reach in our communication with vegetation is when we plant, water, or fertilize it. But it is evident that messages transmitted across an SQ gap of 10 points or more cannot be very meaningful. What then could an SQ plus 50 super being possibly have to say to us? And with that, we come to the end of this video and the end of the Sentience Quotient series. If you enjoyed it, do leave a like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more. Also, with the possibility of a multiverse, how does the upper limit of intelligence change? Could we have alien beings operating at an even higher level of awareness than universality? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.